Latest immigration news. In this video, we'll talk about the latest in immigration. What is going on in immigration? Junguanda here, immigration lawyer in the DC metropolitan area. If you're new to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe. If you're not new, welcome back. Thank you for subscribing. And please don't forget to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. If you enjoy the content, go ahead and share, like, and don't forget to comment below. Some of you guys have been commenting below, asking for a consultation. Just remember that consultation fees apply. If you call my office, what will happen is we will text you back. The generic test will text you back, requiring you to provide your full name and email address so that we can send you a consultation agreement and a link to process payment. Once we receive both, then we'll schedule you for a consultation, because we have to receive the agreement and the payment in order for us to do a proper consultation, pretty much provide you with some type of legal advice or case assessment. That's how it goes. Okay, let's get right into it again. So the first good news is that we're going from good news to good news, okay? So that's why you're seeing me smiling and all that. So the first good news is that President Biden has revoked Presidential Proclamation 9945 of October 4th, 2019. So remember when Trump, the former president, when he was in power, he came up with a proclamation, 9945, which suspended the entry of immigrant who will financially burden the U.S. healthcare system. So basically, you had to show proof of insurance or money to cover your health emergency during your visits in the U.S. And that proclamation really prevented a lot of people from entering the U.S. And Biden went ahead and rescinded that proclamation. Basically, in his proclamation, Biden noted that the proclamation 9945 does not advance the interests of the United States. So basically, if you want to apply to visit the U.S., you don't have to show proof of health insurance or money for health emergency purposes. So that's a good news. Okay, a second good news is that USCIS temporarily suspends biometrics requirement for certain form I-539 applicant. So basically, the form I-539, it's an application to extend or exchange non-immigrant status. So requesting an extension of stay in or change of status to H4 or L2 and E non-immigrant status. Basically, when you're asking for an extend of stay, you use the form I-539. Or you, if you're changing the status from, let's say, for example, changing from H4 to something else, L2 to something else, E to something else, then you use that form as well. So they are actually suspending biometric for requirement, but not for everybody using that form. It says this temporary suspension will apply to applicant filing for form I-539 requesting the following: extension of stay in or change of status to H4 non-immigrant status, extension of stay in or change of status to L2 non-immigrant status, extension of stay in or change of status to E1 non-immigrant status, extension of stay in or change of status to E2 non-immigrant status, including E2C, E2C NMI investor, or extension of stay or change of status to E3 non-immigrant status. So I'm going to leave the link in the description box so you can, if it applies to you, you can just go ahead and read it. So, and then this suspension will apply to those people, only those who they have their application pending as of May 17, 2021 and have not yet received a biometric services appointment, or New applicant postmarked or submitted electronically on or after May 17, 2021. So if by May 17 you haven't received the biometric appointment, they're going to waive it. And if you apply on May 17 electronically too, they're going to waive that requirement of biometric. That's basically what it's saying. And the last final good news is that USCIS citizenship, USCIS, basically the US Citizenship and Immigration Services, is announcing that applicant, petitioner, requesters, and beneficiary, they may now call USCIS contact center to reschedule their biometric services. Remember, previously you had to write, request that rescheduling of your appointment, biometric appointment, you had to write. It had to be in writing, but now you can just pick up your phone and call them. However, you still have to show good cause, really. You still have to show that the reason why you're requesting a change of date. And then that request must be made prior to the date of the interview, which is normal. You can't just do it after, because then the interview is already over, right? That date of biometric appointment will be over if you do it after. So it has to be prior to the date that was scheduled for you. So still have to show good cause. So only three things going on. The first one, Biden has revoked the presidential proclamation suspending entry of non-immigrants if you don't show a proof of health care insurance. And then the USCIS is suspending biometric requirement for certain form I-539 applicants. And then the last one, you can just call to reschedule your biometric appointment, provided that you give them the reason. You have to show good cause. That's it for today. It's Saturday. Happy Saturday. Please don't forget, we're still going to come up here and make the same request that I made yesterday. We're almost reaching 10,000 subscribers. My friend, if you can help me out, I'll help you. In return, I will do 2 live sessions answering your questions. The sooner we get there, the better off you'll be with your questions, especially if you don't want to pay for consultation. So it's better to just keep sharing, keep liking, keep commenting, so that YouTube will show this video with a lot of people that might need to hear those type of information. And once we get there, I'll come back and do my 2 days. It's going to be like a weekend, 2 days live sessions. Really, we are going to go deep and answer your questions, especially if you have those very simple, straightforward questions. Okay, we'll go ahead and answer those questions and just give you a pre-consultation type of advice. Okay, if you want to hear immigration lawyer, the DC metropolitan area. This was U.S. Immigration. Until tomorrow, bye-bye.